Welcome to T2T Boxing. Here with me, I have DY local Kerry Foley, here to chat with us about his beginnings in the sport and a couple of fights you've got coming up. Thanks for coming down, Kerry. Obviously, local fighter, probably the most local interview you've had, living only down the road.
Yeah, 3 seconds, giddy.
Yeah, so tell me a bit about how you got into boxing. I know you've dabbled across a few combat sports, so yeah, how did you get into the sport and what's kept you sort of interested in it?
Yeah, with boxing to start with, probably come down to my brother, to be honest. He was a big boxing fan, and that was when Tyson was kind of at the end of his career with the Lennox Lewis and so on. He'd make me watch the boxing, and he started going down to the boxing gym, and he pretty much just dragged me down there with him, and I just pretty much got hooked. I was a footy player, and it kind of mixed well with, you know, the fitness and stuff, and then pretty much got right into it. And owner of the gym just asked me, said, "Oh, you know, you want to have some amateur fights?" And just pretty much went from there. Yeah.
I see. And how did your amateur career go? How long?
My amateur career was pretty short. So I started boxing around 14, but then the initial gym where I was at closed down. Found one in Manly, and I was there for a couple of years before I actually had an amateur fight. I only got through about 10 fights, and ended up having like a bad motorbike accident, and I was out for, you know, 6 months, almost a year or something, and my trainer said, "Look, you either start again in amateur or you just go straight to pro." And I turned pro at like 18 or something, which is very young for an Australian, you know. Not overseas, but yeah, for Australia.
How did you find that transition between the amateurs and pros?
Yeah, to be honest, my style's always been more of a professional style anyway. I probably transitioned better. I've lost a couple of fights in those amateur fights, just wasn't very suited to it. So yeah, I think that's one of the reasons why we changed.
Yeah, so yeah, I've seen a fight with left hand low, and I pulled up for that myself.
Yeah.
So I know that's always an issue in those amateur fights.
Take punches to land punches, kind of thing.
Yeah,
I mean.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. What would you say has been the biggest challenge for you in boxing in general? Is it is it getting down to weight? Is it picking an opponent or finding an opponent? Because I know people haven't wanted to fight.
Oh yeah, early on in my career when it was always finding an opponent willing to fight. Kind of got a little bit stale as well in my career because I kind of started getting over it because the opponents that we were getting weren't up to my standards, and they were just walkovers, and I kind of just got over it and I started hating it, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Just went through the kind of plateau. You don't improve from, you know, when you're at a certain level and you're fighting people that aren't even worth fighting, you don't really improve. So yeah, that was pretty much it. Yeah.
Absolutely. And then last couple of years been fairly quiet, but you've obviously had those two fights against Robert Berridge.
Last couple of years. So I think it was 3 years ago or something. It was my first match with Berridge, and then I actually went into the cage fighting just because the gym I was in the area.
Yeah.
Out in Penrith. So yeah, I went to a bit of cage fighting, and then my trainer pulled me up and said, "Look, let's go back to boxing," you know. And the first opportunity we got was the Berridge rematch, and we just thought the first time I fought him, I was sitting on the couch like this watching TV, and it would have been the Sunday night, and I just tucked into some Indian mate, and I was sitting on the couch, probably hadn't trained for about 6 months, done nothing out in Penrith, I was sitting at about 96 kilos, and Will Tomlinson was supposed to be fighting on the green tab card, and his opponent didn't jump on the plane, so he didn't come over, yeah. And then I'm sitting next to both of our trainers, because we used to live together, me and Will Tomlinson, and sitting next to him, and he just goes, turns to me, he goes, "Kerry, you want to fight?" I went, "Mate, yeah, TV fight, let's do it." And don't know how they did it, got Berridge, got him to agree to a fight, and they said, "You've got to make 80 kilos, so just pretty much, obviously still no training, I just sat in a sauna and diuretics and just everything, mate, you know. Got down to, I think, 82, even though they were a little bit funny on the weight, I'm like, "Mate, I've just dropped 14 kilos, like, give me a break." And went into the fight just thinking, I'm going to be able to do it, and didn't do my homework. He's southpaw as well, and I've always had a little bit of trouble with southpaws in my career. And came a bit unstuck. Obviously, at the start of the fight, I was fine. I was winning. And then he even got a point taken off him, and then I think it was maybe fifth round, that's when I come unstuck. He just hit me with a punch and I just went down.
Yeah.
Then I actually cracked my skull in, I think it might have been the second or third round, with a head clash, massive head clash, and just from there it was just all blurry. Couldn't really remember much. And he just got me at the end and pretty much I survived for the next two rounds.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was come out with a draw, so.
Yeah, and it definitely did have that real tide turning sort of moment. So I watched it back recently and definitely the first half of the fight seemed to be sort of in control and then
what happened as well is I come in, I was actually a fair bit bigger than him and I was just towards the end of the fight I was walking into him and just like keeping my hands down. I was really comfortable and he's obviously a counter puncher and he's really awkward and he just threw a couple of punches and just landed and just, you know, put me down. So
these things happen, and then went into cages for a while, and then...
Went to the cage for a while.
Then came back.
Then came back, yeah. My trainer's like, look, I even won a title in the cage. The level in Australia for cage fighting is obviously not the best standards. They're quite new over here. And there's just no money in it, mate. You can't make a career out of it. So yeah, my trainer's just like, come back to go boxing. I've got some good contacts, you know. It's where you've already built your foundation. So let's go from there. And the first fight back was we got a Berridge, got the Berridge rematch.
That was a good fight as well.
Yeah, it was a great fight actually. Like, definitely the hardest of my career. Took me to depths I've never been before. We took the fight. We're like, look, especially the last fight, I hadn't trained and everything. Just the preparation wasn't right. And this one, we're like, if we can prepare right. And don't get me wrong, I was very fit for this fight. Probably the most prepared I've ever been. Got some great sparring. I was very fit. Went into the ring. Felt good on the night. And I think I ended up breaking my hand in the fifth. And then probably didn't tell my trainer until about the seventh. But yeah, just couldn't. In the tenth, just couldn't keep going, mate. Yeah. That was just the end. So.
Well, it was probably fight of the night.
Yeah.
And definitely stole the show. I remember when we were watching it, it was a bit blurry, so had a few beers at that time. Yeah. But it was I do remember being very excited about that and certainly all action. That seems to be a lot of your fights have had that element to it, and I guess that's why people come back and want to watch you.
Yeah, that's it.
Want to watch you fight. On that note, a couple of fights coming up. A bit about those.
Two fights in the near future. 14th of November, fighting at Daniel Hurstville. It's a smaller car, but guy Faris Chevalier, he's actually a French guy. He's only had one loss, so he's coming to fight. And then after that one, he's another southpaw as well. We figured I've just come off one of the best southpaws available. And then December 3, we've been given an Australian title opportunity against Trent Broadhurst, whose only loss is to Robert Berridge.
Right.
So yeah, it should be good. And he's obviously ranked number one at the moment. I'm ranked number two in the ratings, so it'd be like a good Australian title.
Yeah, and unusual to see, as you say, one and two sort of fighting each other for these sort of local titles.
I've actually seen Aussies fight people from Philippines or Thailand to get an Australian title. I don't know how they do it, but yeah, I've seen fights like that go about.
Some smart promotions, obviously. So how can people get tickets to those fights or watch those fights if they want to come down?
Hurstville Entertainment, it's J&I promotion. You can Google just J&I if you want to come to that one. December 3 one is going to be on a Foxtel main event card, so either go down to a pub and watch it on Foxtel, or you can head down. I think it's actually at the Cronulla Shark Stadium. It's a Grange promotion, so I think it's the Gallon, what's his name,
Kimbo Slice. Yeah, that should...
So I'll be undercarding that one.
You'd have to do well to steal the show on that night.
Yeah, that's exactly it.
Alright, perfect. Well, I think that's it's definitely something to look forward to. And in terms of if those fights go as planned and say come away with the Australian title coming into next year, have you got plans as to where you want to take that next?
Yeah, definitely, mate. Oz title, maybe defend it to mid next year, and then Berridge trilogy for sure. That's on my mind. And then after that, I know it's going to be a war because it's just our styles. They clash, you know what I mean?
Yeah,
styles. There's just some styles. Some fighters have the styles. And he's still got it. Hopefully he's PABA at the time. Take that and head to Japan. That's my plan.
That's the plan. All right. Well, you heard it here first. It's definitely coming up. Thanks a lot for coming down and speaking to us. We'll obviously keep in touch as we come up to the fights, and we'll keep everyone, you know, up to date with what's going on with yourself, and you know, drop in whenever you fancy a chat.
Yeah, cool.
Appreciate that.
Thank you, mate.
Thanks, Gary.
Thank you.